The DE of the Ministry of Finance raised several issues. I have the copy of the minutes, sir. I have the copy of the minutes. From the minutes I am quoting. It is stated that neither the Airport Authority of India nor the Ministry of Civil Aviation had submitted details of the breakup of project cost to the PPPAC for its consideration. The PPP cell of the DEA recommended that since the six airport development projects are highly capital intensive, a clause should be incorporated that not more than two airports would be awarded to a single bidder because of the high financial risk involved and the need for stringent adherence to performance indicators. The DEA were also suggested that in the case of there was a project failure, there would be other capable bidders available to take on the failed projects. The DEA specifically mentioned that when private companies bid for the development of the airports in Delhi and Mumbai airport, this was happened in UPA period, the contracts to develop both the airports were not given to the same bidder. That time the GMR group was the only qualified bidder, then also they didn't get Delhi and Mumbai. The department also cited the example of privatization of the power distribution network in Delhi, wherein contracts were given to more than one bidder. Sir, the Niti Aayog specifically suggested that request for proposal, RFP, should include criteria to measure the experience of the bidder in developing airports, terminal and related sectors. Curiously, none of the recommendations made by either the DEA or the Niti Aayog were included in the bid documents. You have to understand, sir, the Public-Private Partnership Appraisal Committee, constituted by government, decided to go along with the decision of EGOMS that prior airport experience not to be made prerequisite for bidding and post-bidding requirement. Why this violation happened, sir? For whom it has happened? Only to favour a company. This all bypassing of the norms and guidelines has happened, sir.
There's
a move to monopolize the Indian airports. In future, you can see that entire airports of India will owned by only one company.
Crony
Capital. How can we allow, sir? How can we allow this, sir? Therefore, many industries also complained that the timeline for the entire bidding process was extremely short given. There are also anomalies in the eligibility terms and conditions set by AIA for bidders. If, for instance, the minimum technical and financial capacity for qualifying bidders were surprisingly identical. How can it, sir? The airport of Jaipur is different between the airport of Thiruvananthapuram. The same clause, sir, identical. How can it be happened? Sir, one more thing I have told you. Now the Airport Authority of India become AAA, Airport Authority of Adani.